In order to do this problem correctly, you must first apply the order of operations to each step, making sure that you apply them in the correct sequence. The first step is to do any grouping symbols. We generally just call these parentheses because we use parentheses more than any other grouping symbol, but we work on the inside to simplify as much as we can inside any of the grouping symbols: parentheses, brackets, braces, absolute values, and so forth. So in this particular problem, we do have a parentheses step. We need to work inside the parentheses and work those out. Well, inside there, we have the square root of 36. Remember, the square root of 36 is asking what number would I square so that the result would be 36. And of course, that number is 6, because 6 times 6, or 6 squared, is 36. So the square root of 36 is saying, what do I square to get 36? That is 6. Then I would subtract, and I would need to do the 2 cubed, and that of course is 2 times 2 times 2, which results in 8. Finishing up the step inside the parentheses, we have to continue to work inside the parentheses. We have 6 minus 8. 6 minus 8 would be negative 2. After parentheses comes any exponents. Even within the grouping symbol that I completed here, I still followed the order of operations because square root is also a grouping symbol, a parentheses symbol, and I did that first. That's where I got the 6. Then I did the exponent next. The 2 cubed gave me the 8, and of course finishing up inside of there, I did the subtraction. After completing inside the parentheses, we then have to continue following our orders. There are no other parentheses steps to do inside. This one's complete inside. My exponents, my 4 squared would be my next step, and 4 times 4 is 16, so I would have 16 minus negative 2. After exponents comes multiplying or dividing. These two are said to be of the same order, meaning you can do multiplication first, or maybe you'll do division first, depending on the problem, and it all depends on which one comes first as you work the problem going from the left to the right. So as you go through the problem from left to right, if division is first, you'll do it first. If multiplication is first, you would do it first. In this case, neither one applies, so we skip that step. And our final step is to do any adding or subtracting. And they also are of the same order. You would do whichever of those comes first in the problem, left to right. So in this problem, I do only have subtraction. Well, remember, subtraction can be solved by changing to addition. And also not only changing subtraction to addition, but changing the sign behind it to the opposite. So my negative 2 would change to positive 2, leaving the result of adding 16 and 2 together to give the final answer of 18.